so I'll concentrate on a few things. How to correct DPOD in the hypospadias center, the most important thing is to examine the patient under anesthesia. And number one, as you see here on your left, the penis actually is no tethering at all. Here there is tethering, and the tethering is proximal to the meatus. Here is tethering, and the tethering is distant to the meatus. So in other words, if you divide the skin here, there is a reasonable chance that you have a straight penis. If you do, here you have to divide and deepen the parts. We all know or have heard of the artificial erection test, where you inject saline. You can inject it through the glands or directly through the corpora, and you can see if the penis is straight or curved. But what is relatively new is the natural erection test, where we apply pressure and massage starting from the anus distally. You make the penis congested, as normally happens during normal erection. And this can help you to identify the PD. This is a child about 12 years old. The mother took a picture when he has a normal erection, when he's awake. And this is what she sent me. We did, this is the massage and pressure on the inner perineum, and you got even stronger erection. You don't need to inject saline using a tourniquet and have edema or tissues. Dr. Fauzi is supposed to do a study compare how accurate the natural erection in comparison with artificial erection. That should be the video. How we do the natural erection test. You press at the perineum and push the blood forward. And you can see you get hard penis and you can assess the severity of it. Now, I mentioned already that superficial pelvic, the tethering is proximal to the meatus, just like what you see here. So when you incise proximal to the meatus, the penis will be straight like this, and the skin edge will be flat proximal. This is the chart I showed before, and when you incise here, you see the skin edge has retracted, and the penis of the chart has been about 2 centimeters. This is in relation to superficial PD. When you are dealing with the grade 2 DPOD, there are 4 points. When to operate, ventral degloving, not complete degloving. And what I would recommend is to use the tail procedure and abdominal fixation. These 4 things are important. Why? Timing is important. Because if you operate early, especially in the patient with severe PD, you can save these children from having corporeal disproportion. Because if you wait until the child is 5-6 years old, the dorsal side of the penis is grown without any problem, and the ventral side of the penis is hindered due to the fibrous tissue. So even a child who has no corporeal disproportion, when you delay surgery or correction of the body, if you want to correct urethroplasty or do urethroplasty later, that is not a problem. But please, please correct the body as early as possible. Finally, we operate as early as 6 months. You see this child had severe Chordee. When you operate early, you have the straight penis with the erection test. evidence as early as 1931, Cicero reported this. His pathology did an autopsy of a 10-year-old boy that showed atrophy of the cells on the concave surface of the corpora of the nose. In the Hypospadias Center, we treated about 150 patients with perineal hypospadias. If you operate before 9 months, only two have corpora disproportion. If you operate after 12 months, 14 have corpora disproportion. We already mentioned that the protein tissue is present ventrally, so why on earth you do dorsal deglutting or complete deglutting? The idea is to excise all the hypoplastic disorganized tissue on the ventral aspect, exactly as you see here, to have a straight penis. The concept of the TAVE procedure. TAVE stands for tunica amplovenia longitudinal excision. This means that, here. The tunica amplovenia has two layers, inner circular layer and outer longitudinal. You know, just think of the penis as the car tire. When you look at the rubber so that it can withstand a lot of pressure, it's made in layers. So the penis is the same way, the tunica amplovenia, to survive severe friction and erection, it is made in two layers, inner circular and outer longitudinal. And the outer longitudinal is usually short in severe protein. So when you excise the outer layer, you are maintaining the tunic elements of your patient should not have problem with erectile dysfunction, and you excise the condition. If you operate early, this will be enough in many cases of severe problem. How to do it? Let me just. With the stay suture, you put your finger behind the penis and you start exercising. I'll try to show you this figure. This is a child with severe Chordee. Stay suture. You see we have the scissor as early coronal sulcus. I didn't excise any skin. How it is with every single cut of the scissor and how this skin edge that was already at the coronal sulcus, you see how it is eating? This old skin edge was already here, you know? And then you excise the tissues, the hypoplastic tissues. Here, we did not excise any skin yet. Only the hypoplastic tissue and with the erection test. Before surgery, the penis was about 2 centimeters long. After surgery, it's about 4.5 centimeters. After the Chordee excision, he gained about 2.5 centimeters. And he has a straight penis. After healing, different penis is to show the effect of the tail technique. There are other people doing, like Pippi Sandy, who is doing the fairy cuts. what he does, instead of excising the outer layer, as I do, he just incises it. And he says, he's reporting that he has straight pins for that. This is fine. But what is not fine is that when you do the stack technique and you excise, you incise deep the whole layers of the genic albumin. Because these children will definitely have erectile dysfunction later. Now, I want to talk about fixation to the abdominal wall. After you excise the Chordee, it will be you excise the spot. But without erection, the penis will shrink. So it may hit with 5 doses. And although it may be straight during the surgery, when the penis is not full of blood, it will retract and the Chordee may come back. That's why the standard we do in Frankfurt is we fix to the penis to the abdominal wall under a stretch. This is not difficult and it's not painful, not in children and not in adults. I've been using it since about 4 years now. You don't feel it. Only if you pull the penis with the suture, of course it's painful. But nobody will do that. You just use 3 or 4 or ethylene or non-absorbable tissue. You go from inside the gland, so avoid any point scarring, and you fix it to the abdominal wall. Again, you excise this tissue. When the penis is not erected, it may contract and heal that way. You stretch it, it will heal the way you like, and you keep it straight. Corporeal disproportion is something different. You'll see an angle after you do the tail technique, like what you see here. It is a clear angle, not a curve. And what you need to do in these patients is not to do 3 incisions. You do 1 incision, and then you have no chinta abdomen, and then you have to replace it either with dermograft. I use a chinta abdomen flap, or new synthetic material like SIS. Again, this is another who had low supply patient. They came to me at the age of 24 with his girlfriend. The problem is she doesn't feel thing when they're having sexual intercourse, and in addition he has pain. And you see the curvature here. We did this, that was planned to do in 2 stages. First we excise the tunica, the tape technique, and see how they react. And then was, if it is not enough, we'll do the dermograft or tunica again. We did the first operation. The young man and his girlfriend were happy and they were not keen to do incision of the deep layer of the tunic abdomen. When you incise it, either you use tunic vaginalis, as we are showing here, with the pedicle, and you see outer healing how straight it looks, or you use dermograft. And the trick that you find in the webinar to make sure that you excise all the epidermis, you paint it with methylene blue and with a scissor until you see that you have removed the dye, and you take at least 1.5 the size of what you need and you fix it. This is it. This is the graft after being taken. This is not from me, this is from Mark Downs. And this it is really big. You have to take it more because it will contract with you. And see how it looks after complete healing when you came for the second operation. This is the Pichicelli technique with the fairy cuts. I honestly find it very interesting that with central part of the longitudinal layer, you get staining spontaneous. But this is the picture that he showed. I'm sure that he has other tricks like dorsal partition at the same time or something like that. Why I don't do perform dorsal partition? Those who have been to Egypt, you have seen the Nile. And this is the Hotel Nile Tower. You have a can. It is curved on one side. The solution is to correct this curvature and not to curve it from the other side. You get much longer penis when you do lengthening, ventral length rather than dorsal shortening. Why I want the deep operatomies? This is 6 months after deep operatomy. There is no tunic angle. It is exactly similar when you have fracture pain. You all know if you don't prepare the injury and close the injury in the tunic and Virginia, the patient will have erectile dysfunction. Sometimes the persistent and current curvature may be due to scarring. Compare this to patient, this is around 24 years old. Took straight, but he had severe Chordee. This is another man who had about 10 operations with severe Chordee. But when you do extensive ventral deblocking, not complete deblocking, you have really straight penis. Now, just to complete the talk on dorsal Chordee and showing the different forms of dorsal palpation, the original description was by Nesbitt. And first, he did palpation without excision. And the Chordee came. He did that on a medical student. The other possibility is to excise, and then this is permanent. And the third possibility is to do a longitudinal incision at the midline 12 o'clock and close it transversely. The advantage is it is said that at midline 12 o'clock there are no nerves. Nerves are between 11 laterally. So if you incise deep in the midline at 12 o'clock, there is no danger of injuring the nerves. And they reported good results, but all these, most of those patients come later at puberty with recurrent Chordee. This is by Perovich. This is one of his patients. He was a famous penile surgeon and others. He did a lot of work in Crohn's disease and lengthening and enlargement of the penis. He did complete disassembly. He would mobilize the glands with the neurovascular bud with the urethra, straighten the penis and fix them back again. I never dared to do this. The last possibility is to split and roll, where you divide the two corpora from each other and rotate them and suture them together, but I've never done that as well. Again, patient with severe Chordee, either you shorten the penis or you lengthen and correct the pathology. This is very important. When we operate on a child with hypospadias or Chordee, what is our aim? Is to satisfy the surgeon or the patient and his girlfriend. This is a study done in Switzerland, in Zurich, and they showed normal penises and penis this is after Hypospadias is born. And they have to read which penises are nice, what is which penis is good looking and which is not. And it turned out the overall cosmetic result was number one priority. Number two priority was the penis of the pubic hair. Nothing to do with the penis or the hypospadias. Number three, the spine of the penile skin, the penile length. Number four, I can't see it. I think three, penile girth and penile skin. Number five, shape of the glands. The least important, which due to personal reasons was made the most important thing in hypospadias surgery, is to have a slit-like latus at the tip of the glands. As if all men walk in the streets, they are sure, you see, I have a slit-like latus. I'm not sure that this is the case in many countries, maybe in the States. Thank you.